Благословен Бог наш, всегда ныне и присно, и во веки и веков.
To the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, blot out our sins. O Master, pardon our iniquities. O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in the heavens, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. Amen. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Господи помилуй, Господи помилуй, Господи помилуй, Господи помилуй. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O come, let us worship God our King. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ our King and our God. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ himself, our King and our God.
Живи в помощи Вышнего, в крови Бога Небесного водворится. Речет Господи, заступник мой, еси, прибежище мое, Бог мой, и уповаю на Него. Я готов избавить от сети ловчи, от слове си мятежно, плечма своему синица, и под крылья Его надеешься. Оружием увидит тебя истина Его, не убоишься от страха ночного, от стрелы летящего дни, от вещи от мне приходящего, от царя небеса полуденного. Падет от страны Твоя тысяча, и тьма одесную Тебе, к Тебе же не приближится. Убачи очима Твоим осмотришь, и воздаяние грешников узришь. Яко Ты, Господи, упование мое Вышнего положилось, и прибежище Твое. Не придет к Тебе злой раны, не приближится телеси Твоему. Яко ангелом своим заповестью Тебе сохранить Тебя во всех путях Твоих. На руках возьмут Тебя, да никогда приткнешь ее камень ногу Твою. На аспиде Василиска наступишь, и поперешь льва и змея. Яко на мя уповаю, избавлю и покрою, яко познай имя мое. Воззовет ко мне, и услышу его. С ним есть в скорби из моего, и прославлю его. Долго той дни исполню его, и явлю ему спасение мое.
Благослови Иисусе Господи, научи меня оправдание Твоим.
Thank you.
Христе Боже наш, и Тебе славу посылаем со бесконечным Твоим Отцем, и пресвятими благими животворящим Твоим Духом, и ныне и присно и во веки веков.
Amen. Salvation through the mankind perish.
Святым и благим и животворящим Твоим Духом, ныне и присно и во век и веков.
Слава Господи, Сыну и Святому.
učinil jesi, preslušša že tvoju zapoved, izgnal jesi, tem že roba tvojego dušu spase upokoj. Zostavi jemu prežde našu pramatr, iz prečistego tvojego čreba obhod odjevajeca, jej uže smrt i krepost čistaja razruši.
Yeah.
нашегося ныне упокой.
Упокой, Господи, душу уславшего раба Твоего.
И свяченную славою Твоею, когда приидешь и страшно судит и миру всему на облицах, благоволи светло срести Тебе, Избавителю, якоже Отцем и приял еси верного раба Твоего.
Господи, Сыну и Святому Духу,
источник жизни сии, мужеством божественным владико, окованья и злодья и раба Твоего, к Тебе верно, отшедшего во сладости и расти в себе. Землю возвратихомся, преступще Божье заповедь, а Божественью Тобою же Деву на небо оценни, вознесохомся, тью смертную отвястье.
Now and ever and unto the age.
Твоего веки
И выше всякие твари пренепорочная была еси, зачем же Бога сокрушившего смертная врата и вери истершего, тем же тебя чистой песнословием верни, яко Богоматерь.
Благодати,
да
оправдан кровью плащенного из твоего чрева все непорочное.
Папи, папи, миром Господу помолимся.
Thank you.
paradise because of his repentance. Vouchsafe this also to me, the unworthy.
The way in which thou shalt go today, O soul, for a resting place is prepared for thee. Thou shalt go today, O soul,
for a resting place is prepared for thee.
Wisdom.
Reading is from the Epistle of the Holy Apostle Paul to the Thessalonians.
Let us attend.
Brethren, I would not have you be ignorant concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not precede them who are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we always be with the Lord.
Peace be unto thee.
And to thy spirit,
wisdom.
The Alleluia is in the sixth tone. Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
Sermon
that will be given in English, or part of the service will be in English, or when he was making illegal shortwave radios to listen to the BBC in his closet, he wasn't thinking about the fact that he would be having a funeral service in America, where most everyone, in fact, everyone who is present, speaks English. There's a wonderful saying that we have in the church, that man proposes and God disposes. And the Lord disposed that Yuri should live out his life here in America. And for us, I may say, at least for me, it was a blessing. I didn't get to spend as much time with him as I would have liked to. I had plans to go and listen to him. I liked his accent very much. It was kind of a little Russian with a little British and a little bit of American thrown in. It was very unique, and it was very pleasant to listen to him and to talk to him about all kinds of different things. And when I think of him and the family that he raised under really quite difficult circumstances, and to see how they came out, really we have to say that this is probably something that would be close to a miracle. That in a system that was officially against faith, that could come from this family so much faith. And because of faith, we approach death differently. In the world, death is the end. As the top of the coffin is closed, so is closed the chapter. In fact, not just a chapter, but the entire book of a life. But for those who believe, when the coffin is closed and the body is committed to the earth, yes, a chapter is closed. Maybe even the preface, we may say, of the book. Because all of us will live a lot longer in eternity than we will live in this life. It was a real privilege that I had to be present when Father Vladimir was visiting last time. We were able to bring the holy gifts to Yuri, and he was able to partake of the holy mysteries, to confess, and to commune. Most of us don't get to experience that, and that's a shame. That is, that real confession, that real emptying of oneself when we know that death is coming. Because basically, let's be honest, we deny that we will be in that place. We see him there. We know somehow in the back of our mind that someday we will be there. But we won't think of it. We won't prepare ourselves really for it. Maybe in a small way. But when someone is already committed to their home and can't really go out, when their life is drawing near to its end, the confession and the communion of someone like that, it's so spiritual. It's like watching someone with one foot in this life and another in the next. And we as priests, we get the blessing to see this. And certainly this strengthens our faith. And knowing that such things exist, hopefully it strengthens the faith of all of us as well. Because, brothers and sisters, that's why we are here. If we didn't have faith, if we didn't have hope, if we didn't believe that Christ rose from the dead, and that we too will rise, then we could be doing something else this afternoon. But because we do believe that Christ rose from the dead, and that we too will rise, then here we are, caring for one who has gone on before us. We have a very nice way of saying that someone has died in the church. There are actually a couple of ways. Someone has reposed in the Lord. That's nice. But the one that I like the best is, this person has fallen asleep in the Lord. How true that is. And we sort of think of it as sometimes, well, that's a quaint way. That's a nice way. Well, that's true. It's absolutely true that when we die in this life, we are only falling asleep because we will awaken when the Lord comes again. And we do not sleep like the sleep of someone who doesn't understand what's happening around them. Not at all. The soul is very aware of what is happening. It's hyper aware because no longer is it held down by the ties of the body, the sickness, the sorrows, the difficulties of this life. The soul can fly. And it does. And it flies to the Lord. And especially for the family, I think it's important to understand. When we are there, when our soul can fly to the heavenly kingdom, we will know him. It won't be some unknown person. He will be there. So, brothers and sisters, some of the saints say that someone who has died is the best teacher, even better than someone who lives. Because not only has that person imparted to us the wisdom that they had in this world, but now they impart to us the wisdom of the next. That is, that deny it as we may, hope against hope, that we might, we will all find our place here, moving on to the next world. So we have our choice. As is often true for us who believe in Christ, we can either go towards the end of our life with joy, happiness, preparing ourselves to meet the Lord for what we have waited for and hoped for and struggled for our whole life. Or we can do this sort of theological ostrich approach and put our head in the sand and hope that it will not happen. But at the risk of breaking paradigms, I hate to tell you, it will. So let's decide today that we will learn from Yuri Simonovich. We will not just say, oh, it's too bad that he's gone. Too bad for whom? For him? Not at all. Not in the least. For us? Okay. That's fair. That we miss this person, that this person that we love has gone before us. It's okay for us to be sad for that reason. But for him, completely ridiculous. Because he is where he has prepared himself to be. He is where we all should prepare ourselves to be. He is in the true homeland of all. He has begun his travel to the heavenly kingdom. So, brothers and sisters, let's not sort of quiet ourselves with platitudes and say, oh, too bad for old Yuri because he's now died. Too bad for us? Yes. Too bad for him? Never. Because for him, he has gone to where we all will go, where he prepared himself to go. So, brothers and sisters, let us care for those who have gone before us. Let us pray for the repose of their souls, because we know that they also pray for us. Weep for ourselves, yes, but not for the repose, because they have gone to the place that the Lord has prepared for them. And may he prepare such a place for us also. Amen.
Господи помилуй. святым его учеником и апостолом, поеже взязати и решити греки человеков, рек им, примите Духа Святого, и че отпустите греки, отпустите им, им же держите, держаться, и велика аше свяжете и разрешите на земли, будут связана и разрешена и на небеси. От он некше и на ни друг, другу приимательно, пришедшею, да сотворить чрез мене смиренного прощенно, и сие по духу чада Георгия, от всех велика яко человек согреши Богу словом, или делом, или мыслью, и всеми своими чувствами, волю или неволю, ведением или неведением, аше же под клапою или от отлучением аргирейским или ерейским блист, или аше клятву отца своего или матри своя наведенася, или своему проклатью подпаде, или клятву приступи, или иными некими греки, яко человек связася, но и о всех сих сердцем сокрушенным покаяся, и от тех всех вини и юзи да разрешить его, елика же на немощь естества забвенью предаде и та вся да простить ему, человеколюбия ради своего, молитвами пресвятия, и преблагословения владычицы нашей Богородицы и престолеве Марии, святых славных и всех полных апостол и всех святых. Аминь.
Now, brothers and sisters, we will approach and give the last kiss to the departed as we place in his hand the prayer of absolution, which we have just read before him. Thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Thank you.
чадливости ко мне. Святое согрешение соделано им, словом и дарами и помышлением. Яко благий человек любит Бога прости, яко нес человек нищий будет ими согрешить. Ибо и вин кроме века оправда твоя оправдывал, як и слово твоя истина. Яко ти есть воскресение и живот и покой и усопшего раба твоего, того преславленного Георгия Христе Боже наш. И тебе славу посылаем со безначальным твоим отцем, и с пресвятими благими благодарящим твоим духом, ныне и пресно и во веки веку.
Работ твоему, Георгию.
Братья и сестры, can we, brothers and sisters, can we have your attention? Внимание, пожалуйста, братья и сестры.
Я хотел
Владимир хочет
выразить свою благодарность отцу Григорию, вам всем, его духовным детям, за такую любовь, которую я ощущаю. Это, конечно, чудо, такая любовь. Но такую любовь я ощущаю, ощущал, когда меня руку полагали на день блудного сына.
I'd like to thank Father Gregory and all of you for the love I feel. And the same kind of love I only felt in the day when I was ordained to be a priest in the day of prodigal son.
И мы все должны ощущать, что Бог нам дает все даром. И я ощущаю сейчас, что совершенно не заслуживаю такой любви от вас, дорогие мои сестры. И желаю, чтобы Господь вам дал вашу любовь, чтобы эта любовь была с вами. Потому что если любовь есть, то она, конечно, даст человеку, который ей обладает, эту любовь, она дает ему, в нем дает уже жизнь вечную. Как вот сейчас мы в Евангелии слышим, что кто слушает словес моих и верует в послание, имеет все жизнь вечную. Я желаю, чтобы у вас так и была у вас пребывала эта любовь, чтобы была у вас эта жизнь вечная.
And we all must know and remember that God gives every sin for free to us. And Father Vladimir doesn't feel worthy of our love. And he says that if we keep this kind of love, then we will attain eternal life. Because as I said in the gospel, we heard that this is the way to the love.
Это для нас, мы всегда рады вас видеть, но это, к сожалению, вы здесь, вы ваше лицо, но, конечно, это, когда вы тут, мы чувствуем, как вы часть нашей приходской семьи, и если Бог даст, вы продолжаетесь и будете у нас, ну, если Бог даст, вам живет 20 лет, еще и вы будете у нас много раз.
И прошу молиться за папу. Но мне когда приходится отпевать, то утешаешь родственников, но и говоришь, что вы думали не только о скорби своей, но думали об усопшем. Потому что страшна не смерть, а страшны мытарства. Суд Божий. И вот Господь на свое милосердие, вот мытарство это как бы экзамен. Экзамен. И вот стоит школьник перед доской и не знает, что отвечать. И молитвы церкви, это Господь нам разрешает подсказывать нашему усопшему. Подсказывать. Мы им говорим, потому что какая истина на том, что мы не своими добрыми делами спасаемся. Если человек будет с весами спорить и доказывать, что я хороший, я то-то и то-то делал, он никогда их не переспорит. Господь дает все даром, но только говорит, Господи, я грешный, но ты за меня распялся, я верую, что ты за меня умер, и тогда бес уже будет как ты я. И так что молитесь за папу, моего.
Please pray for Father Vladimir, and it's not the death that is so scary. What is scary is the
toll houses. Toll houses.
Toll houses. The tests that the demons is gonna throw on us on the age. And if you imagine a student standing in front of a blackboard and trying to answer the questions that they're throwing, the prayers of the church is the thing that God allows us to do, to help, to whisper in the ear of this student the right answer. And this is the help we can give, and we must.
Thank you, Lord. Precious name.